Good morning, class 8. Welcome back to your biology classroom once again. Hope all of you watched the last video. Today I am going to start trophic levels and pyramid of numbers. So look at your book. The various steps representing organisms in a food chain at which transfer of food and energy takes place are called trophic levels. So what is trophic levels? The various steps representing organisms in a food chain at which transfer of food and energy takes place. So it is a kind of food chain whereas food and energy just transfer from one level to another level. This representation is also known as trophic levels. The various trophic levels are green plants or producers that fix the solar energy constitute the first trophic level. Herbivores or primary consumers constitute the second trophic level, for example, snails, rabbit, deer and goat. Next, carnivores or secondary consumers that feed on herbivores constitute the third trophic level, for example, snakes, frogs, small birds and small fish. And the large carnivores, I mean top carnivores or tertiary consumers that feed on the small carnivores constitute the fourth trophic level, for example, eagle, tiger and lion. So actually there are four trophic levels. Trophic levels are the collection of food chain whereas food and energy just transfer from one level to another. Look at the figure here. First trophic level just consists of producers, I mean green plants, those who are able to produce their own food. Then primary consumers, again secondary consumers, and the last one is the finalers are tertiary consumers or top carnivores. So normally jitna hi hum log upar se niche se upar tak jayenge utna hi level chota hote ja raha hai aur us hisab se food and energy jo transfer ho raha hai ek level se aur dusra level pe wo bhi decrease ho raha hai. A food chain operating a grassland ecosystem like corn. Here is corn as a producer. Next, first primary carnivore, that is primary herbivores, that is rat, again snake, and the top carnivore is eagle. The trophic levels in the above food chain are as follows. Corn, here as corn act as a first trophic level, then rat act as a second trophic level, and the third one is snake, third trophic level, and the last one is the top carnivore act as an eagle, whereas a fourth trophic level. The various trophic levels in a food chain can also be shown by a pyramid of numbers. It shows that at the first trophic level, the number of organisms are larger than the other levels. However, as you move from one to next trophic level, the number of organisms then decreases. So look at the figure here. That is the pyramid of number, whereas the number of producers is larger than all kinds of consumers. Then hum jitna hi upar tak jayenge utna hi pyramid chota hota ja raha hai aur number of organism wo bhi kam hota ja raha hai. So as you can see, there are 10 to 12 plants at the lowest trophic level. The number of herbivores at second trophic levels are 5 to 6. The number of carnivores at the third trophic levels are 3 and 4. And the number of carnivores at the highest peak trophic level is only 1. So normally, from here se samajh mein aa raha hai, to jitna hum log niche se upar tak jayenge, number of organism as well as फूड और एनर्जी जो सप्लाई हो रहा है एक लेवल से दूसरे लेवल पे वो भी कम होता जा रहा है और नंबर ऑफ ऑर्गेनिज्म वो भी कम होता जा रहा है. नेक्स्ट, एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स. नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स इन द एनवायरनमेंट आर कॉल्ड इट्स एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स. एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स इंक्लूड एयर, वाटर, सॉइल एंड क्लाइमेटिक फैक्टर. सो व्हाट आर एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स? नॉन लिविंग substance which are essential for the maintaining the ecosystem, these are act as a abiotic components, such as air, water, soil and climatic factors such as sunlight, temperature, humidity and wind. Also each of these has a specific influence on the life or process of various organism. First of all, air. All living organism on earth need air to live. Green plants, use carbon dioxide from air to make food and give out oxygen. This oxygen is used by living organism for respiration. So normally green plants produce oxygen. Same way we intake oxygen for our respiration process. Next, gases in the atmosphere are cycled. Thus, there is a balance of gases in the air. Unfortunately, human beings are disturbing this balance by their activities like deforestation and the excessive burning of fossil fuels causes increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So the main two conditions are responsible for the increasing carbon dioxide in the air, that is deforestation and the excessive burning of fossil fuels. Next, the nitrogen present in the air is converted to nitrates in the soil by the microorganism. These nitrates are then used by the green plants. Air helps in the regulating the temperature on earth. It absorbs excess solar heat and does not let the days get too hot. It also prevents the heat of the earth to escape, thus protecting us from the freezing nights. So actually heat, normally sunlight ko air absorb karne ke liye, hum logo ka solar energy jo normally absorb kar leta hai, is dauran day ke time air, matlab hum log thanda mehsoos kar sakte hai, aur raaton ke time ye heat absorb hone ke liye, escape matlab usko prevent karta hai. Is dauran kya hota hai, hum log raat mein jo freezing night फील नहीं करेंगे. नेक्स्ट, वाटर. वाटर इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. ऑल मेटाबॉलिक एक्टिविटीज सच एज द डाइजेशन, एक्सक्रीशन एंड द सर्कुलेशन ऑकर विद वाटर एज द मीडियम. ग्रीन प्लांट्स नीड वाटर टू प्रिपेयर फूड. वाटर इज ऑल्सो द मेन कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ द ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. For example, the human body consists of 60-70% water by weight. So student, इसके नीचे underline करना. This line is mainly very important. Basically, हम लोग का जो body mass है उसका 60-70% is water. The amount of water and the rainfall in a region affect the kind of plants and animals found there. For example, desert region where there is scarcity of water have less vegetation, whereas the western ghats and Assam that receive heavy rainfall, there are dense evergreen forest. So normally rainfall jahan pe kam hoga, I mean the scarcity of water is responsible for the less vegetation, whereas which region get the heavy rainfall, there is a dense evergreen forest. Water in rivers, lakes, ponds and ocean is also home to the many living organisms. So student, hope all of you understood what I've discussed in this video. So for today, up to this portion.